Thank you. Welcome to IoT Talks 2023. We are so glad to have you here, so many coming from all over Sweden, from all over Europe, some of you from China, some of you from Americas. It's such a pleasure to see you in the beautiful Stockholm, even more beautiful with the snow now, isn't it? I think one of the most glamorous cities we can have in Europe. But I'm also like to welcome all our digital attendees joining from all over the world. Big, big welcome to all of you. We have, sorry, I'm taking my notes, just forget it. The 10 years we have been driving that business has been very successful. It has been a roller coaster, of course, like every business, but overall a big success for us in the last 10 years. I haven't come back to some of the achievements we have been having in the last 10 years. First, 10 years of consecutive growth on our top line. We are very proud of it. It's thanks to all of you, our customers, obviously, and partners that we can make it. But we have done it for 10 years, and we will continue. But also, we are now in the top 10 European connectivity player. We started 10 years ago a bit behind the others, but we have been catching up very fast. That's something also we're proud of it. We have reached 10,000 customers. Some of them are direct customers, like some of you here, and some of them are indirect customers through our value-added resellers. And some of you have been with us many, many years from the beginning. And finally, 10 million connections. That's what you have all deployed with us across the world. We have connection in 190 countries in the world, and we are really also proud of that achievement. There is another number that is not related to 10, which is 54. What does it stand for, this 54? It's about NPS, Net Promoter Score. If you're not familiar with it, it's how we measure the satisfaction of our customers. And it starts from minus 100 to plus 100. We have achieved 54 2 weeks ago from all our customers' feedback, which is much above industry standard. And we are really proud and happy to get that positive feedback from all of you, our customers. But Tele2 IoT would not be where we are here without the support and the strength of the Tele2 Group. Tele2 Group, as you know, has been invested from the beginning on IoT, keeps investing, and will continue investing in the coming months and years because they are super engaged in that IoT business. But before all, Tele2 is a purpose-driven company. And our purpose is to enable a society of unlimited possibilities. And guess what? IoT is really at the heart of it. We really serve and contribute to the purpose of the company. But your companies as well are purpose-driven technology companies, I'm sure. So whatever the application in IoT you can find in the market, whatever the IoT solution, there is not a single one you can challenge me that is not contributing to a better world, to a safer world, not helping any company to do their digital transformation. So we are all working for a more sustainable world. And the world deserves it, because as you know, it's more and more important in these days to help for a better world, because there are some wars around us, the viruses, energy crisis, consequence of the wars, and so on. So that doesn't look so good, to be honest. So I think we should reflect individually and collectively, what can we do even more together? How can we push the boundaries of IoT to the sky so that really we leave to our future generation, our kids, a better planet? So that's what I invite you to reflect on. Now, if we look at the IoT market itself, I think it's a fantastic market. We all enjoy it. It's a growing market. It's a mature market. It's not anymore hype since many years ago. If you look only at the cellular connection in the world, it's more than 3 billion connections that are active. And it's more than 350 million only in Europe. So that's a fantastic market that keeps growing double digit. And even better, it is boosted by new technologies dedicated to IoT. You've probably heard about now about IoT, LTE-M, but also EUICC, eSIM, and now iSIM. And you will hear more about it. All these technologies will unlock the IoT market to what we call the mass market. And that will make us all happy for the next years, I would say. But we should continue to develop that IoT ecosystem, but we should also be smart and embrace other technologies. For example, AI. Talked a bit about AI. AI is really complementary of IoT. The data is generated by all the IoT devices in the world that is growing will be fantastic, beneficial from AI technology for network reliability, for customer service, and so on and so on. By the way, today in our innovation hub that you can see some of our customers, they will be at the Amazon booth. The first demo we have been doing, showing you a bit what is our vision for AI. It's just the first step, but it's important that you see how do we see, how we see AI for the future. So today, during the entire day, you will see a lot of customer stories on stage. You know we love to bring our customers on stage because I think that's the one they are expert in their IoT solution. You will see a lot of customers and demos in the Innovation Hub that illustrate that deep IoT love we have, that DNA, that passion we have for IoT that is in our DNA from the entire team. And I would just end up with a single then question for all of you. How deep is your IoT love then? Thank you.
We were going to come up here dancing, but we realized I'm a bad dancer and Anton's even worse, and we can't compare with you, Cyril.
I'm a good dancer, but not a bad singer. But.
Yeah. So, Anton, how deep is your love for IoT?
Well, let me tell you something. I've been here for a while, and my IoT love is probably deeper than the Grand Canyon, I must say. But either way, Cyril, my question to you is actually about the feelings and stuff. So how does it feel to be here on stage celebrating this wonderful 10-year journey?
No, I think you feel it. I'm super happy and super excited. Naturally, I'm excited, but when this even more with 250 customers around. I've not been on the 10-year journey here. I've been 5 years and a half already, and 3 years and a half running the IoT organization. So I'm really proud, first, that's the emotion, of the talented team that has built that business, and also very thankful to the customers that have been loyal to us from the beginning. So that's what I think, proud and emotion.
And so you've only been with, you have been with Tele2 IoT for 5.5 years, but you've been in the industry for a long time, and you've seen a lot of changes. Where do you see the next 10 years going? I know we could talk about it all day, but the brief
That's a
answer.
Classic question. The next 10 years in IoT, you get it everywhere, and you never know how to take it. But if you look at the future years, I think first there will be a continuing consolidation of the market on connectivity, because it's today very fragmented. There are too many players on the connectivity side, I would say, so the consolidation is something that will help our customers to navigate in that IoT market. So that's the first thing I'm seeing. The second one is I think we need to break the silos in IoT. Everybody develops his own IoT application, vertical or horizontal, doesn't matter. But there is no interconnection. There is not an open IoT platform where we could interconnect each other and make it easier. So that's where I see the future. And the last one is healthcare. And we're going to talk about it. Healthcare is only at the beginning. If you look at the number of healthcare devices, the number of sick patient growing, and people getting elder and older and older in the world, there are many, many more we can do in healthcare. It's a very slow process in healthcare, but we are only at the small beginning. It will be big.